Yep.
Interesting.
And just opening up with a quick punish.
Look, look at this.
I'm gonna kind of come to a halt because of Sheik's weight, a little bit trickier to keep those long combos going on her.
Yeah. Mm. Okay. I thought he was gonna grab the ledge, but yeah. I guess he didn't have enough time. Okay. Grabbing ledge.
And yeah, Zane just keeps himself so safe. Like, a lot of times when you think you see openings, they're not there.
They're not there. They're imaginary. That's what he wants you to see.
Like, because I when I watch Smash, I try to see if I agree with what the players are doing. Even if they're better players than me, I'm trying to see, like, is this what I would have done here?
Yeah, exactly.
And I would have done that dash attack on shield, thinking that he couldn't shield. So, I mean, Zane, certainly a player that just...
Yeah. It's definitely easier, like, commentating than playing.
Oh, yeah. I mean, we're just talking.
Yeah, we're just talking about it. Oh, and he messes up a little bit. He got battlefield in. It's unfortunate.
Just waiting there. Just waited. The standoff.
Yeah. It's scary.
Oh, giving up the ledge.
Again, that's the second time it happened. Zane might need to roll up.
Yeah.
Occupy that ledge a little bit longer.
Yeah, there he stabs the needle. For those of you that don't know, Sheik's needles are characters in this game because they can just get hit for whatever reason.
They have hurt boxes.
Yeah.
if Sheik scatters her needles on the ground, if you look at 20XX, they actually have hurt boxes.
Yeah, like, I know.
Shy guys. Okay.
All right, but I mean, Lod. There we go. Got a lot off of that stock advantage.
Yeah, 136 damage and the stock.
Yep.
And the Sheik pick's working out.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Despite Zane's... We know Zane's good at the matchup, but...
But, I mean, just seeing how it comes into play against different players.
Yeah, different styles. Oh, there.
Ooh, no.
Oh, no.
A little too far out there.
That was good DI.
Yep.
On the last one.
Ooh. You know, that was a good roll. I mean... You don't think roll is a good option but sometimes it's just the right thing to do. Get yourself out of that corner.
You need to use it. And people, there's always like this mentality
that
rolling is so bad. But in certain situations, it's the best option you could do.
Yeah. And I mean, Lod's punish game with Sheik is just looking phenomenal.
Yeah.
Right there, just gets the double up air. Gonna
he's
take
winning
the stock.
Neutral more, and he's getting more off his openings.
Yeah.
So this is a pretty good pick. Maybe he's been working on the Sheik.
Yeah. Okay, so gonna take the stock there.
Mm-hmm.
But still, down by quite a bit.
Yep.
And Lod looks content to just play this keep away game.
Yeah, exactly.
And, I mean, his damage is coming in these big bunches.
Mm-hmm. 73,
84, 90. Yeah, just
and still going. And still going. And now he's off station.
That could
he
be
should
it.
Be dead.
Yeah. No.
He rolls up early. Even then, he still has a very commanding position over this game.
Oh, yeah.
Nice tech chase. Ooh, he was a little bit slow on that one.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. He just catches him.
They're just throwing the hands in front of him. Mm-hmm. He caught one of them, and that was game.
We'll see what adjustment Zane makes.
Yeah.
I think his punish game wasn't as good as it was versus Hat, so we'll see if it takes a game or two, you know.
Uh-huh.
Just you know, kick it into gear. Okay, Pokemon Stadium, good counter pick. You can juggle Sheik pretty well. You have two platforms for tippers.
Yeah.
Your up tilt kills pretty early, so just good overall stage for Barth. And these needles are really pestering Zane.
Yeah, it looks like it.
A lot just playing like the keep away game, you know?
Yeah, and like the thing is, when you know that your opponent has the option from a distance, it makes you want to get in on them, and then...
It makes you want to approach.
Yeah, and then Lod, he's just doing this, gets the grab, and then that's... The damage is just racking up.
Yeah. We haven't really seen Zane get anything started. He looks like he's struggling with these long-range needles
from
Lod.
Okay, but now has the opening, nice. And that's going to be the stock. Nice.
And he recovers.
Oh, and he gets back. I thought.
Yeah. No, he saved his jump.
Yeah, it looked like he dipped a little low there, but.
He did the fair to down air without double jumping. Sometimes you need to do that for the Ken combo.
Okay.
It's good recognition by.
Oh, yeah. Definitely knows the character inside and out.
Let's be real. He's done that combo, like, so many times.
Too many times.
Yeah.
Okay, gets the grab.
And no up throw, interesting.
Yeah.
Oh, nice mash out.
He's just opting for the pummels.
Yeah, Lod's doing a good job of mashing out of these grabs. Dane's gonna need to throw a little bit earlier at low percents. Okay.
Just kind of tossing him across the stage and keeping him in the corner.
Yeah, the thing is, I just feel like Lod's really out neutraling Zane right now.
Yeah.
When Zane's had his opens, they haven't been bad. You know, it's look at these needles. Look at this.
Look at that. Like he's trying to get in, and it's just the wall.
Yeah.
The wall of Lod's Sheik is keeping him out.
Yeah. He needs to find a better way to get in and deal with these needles.
Right.
Maybe it does. Maybe adjust his dash dance spacing.
Make ooh. Nice. Or just get the monster punishes there. Yeah.
And
bring it back close.
We're seeing a similar narrative to Smash God vs. Plank, where he's keeping up, you know, but he's never really been in the lead this game.
Right.
And we're seeing that now.
Yeah, you can just see, Lod's just conditioning him into this corner.
Yeah, he's trying to approach, but Lod's making it super hard for him.
Alright, this has to be big.
Yeah, this is big. Okay.
Okay. I mean, he got a good amount of damage.
Yeah. Oh.
So sometimes with Zane, you just assume the stock is gone
exactly.
After a hit.
Exactly. I mean, and it's not a bad assumption to make.
Yeah.
To be fair. This is a hard position for Marth. He doesn't really have good ledge options, but he does a good job of mixing it up.
Okay. Just dips a little too low there and gives up the stock. That kind of sucks because that was a 10 stock and then it just ends so abruptly.
That's a huge momentum switcher.
Yeah.
Again, if he can keep up, he can make it happen the last stock. That's what you want to do. You want to give yourself a chance in the last stock to win the game.
Yeah.
So we'll see what he does here. Oh, okay.
Ooh, okay.
Sheik's roll is very good.
Yeah.
Yeah, that
a ninja.
Roll. Yeah.
Okay, that's
nice up
gonna
tilt.
Do it, yeah.
Yeah, again, this is almost like a mirror match, you know, of a Smash God.
Almost, really.
Like, yeah. Same stage, also.
Yeah. Very similar.
And here's the thing.
Ooh, is he gonna... Is he gonna change fate? Let's see. Has him off stage. Forces the on-stage recovery.
He
gets
antsy.
Hit by the vanish. Ooh. Looked like he dipped above the ledge a little bit, but no punish.
Oh, he spent his double jump. Oh, no, he rolled on the platform.
Ooh.
He didn't grab ledge. Oh, this is so tense right now.
Right.
Oh, this should be it.
That's it.
Oh,
okay.
That's it. Good stuff good stuff to both players.
Yeah, it looks like Lod found his answer to Zane.
Yeah, no, it's...
At least you might think that, you know, these two could easily meet again in Grand Finals.
We'll see what adaptations
or loser finals.
Zane makes.